Hi friends, today we are going to see that if suppose I have a finite word length of resistor and I have an infinite number, then how to fit this infinite number into finite word length resistor. First of all, let us revisit, what do you mean by word length? Word length is a term used to define the number of bits packed to represent a number, which we called as a word. Okay, so the number of bits packed together is called as a word, and the number of bits that are there in that pack is called as a word length. Normally, the word length is defined as B bits. That means I have total B bits in a word length. Okay, so if suppose I have an 8-bit resistor, let's take an example that I'm working with an 8086 family processor, and I have an 8-bit resistor and my number is of, let's say, 10 bits. Okay, by processing I'm getting the number to be 10 bits. How should I fit the 10 bits into 8-bit resistor? So that is a very big question, that how can I fit this 10 bits into 8 bits, right? Now this problem is being solved using two methods, and the first method is called as by truncation, and second method is called as rounding. So we will either be using truncation or we will be using rounding. Now after using truncation or rounding, what is the effect on the design of a digital filter that we have to consider, isn't it? Because if I am truncating or rounding a number, okay, its value will be changed, and with this changed value, what will be the effect on my designed parameters of a DSP? It might happen that I have designed a low pass filter, but due to rounding and truncating, my low pass filter started acting like a band pass filter. Okay, and it is no more passing the DC, and it started and it stopped my DC. So these are the major effects of truncating and rounding. Now what do you mean by truncation and what do you mean by rounding? These two effects I will explain using a decimal digit number instead of binary. Take for example, I have a number 10.20156238.7542, likewise. So after 10 point, this is a huge number. Okay, now in my calc I can show up to 10 digits. Let me count whether they are 10. So 1, 2, 3, this will come as a display. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, that's all. So I can display only this many characters on my display. But the actual number according to calculation also have 8, 7, 5, 4, 2 and so on and so forth, let's say. Then what we would do? We normally, okay, see that if suppose I neglect from 8 onwards, okay, I will consider only 10.20156238 and from 8 onwards I will neglect the number. If I do so, this number is being neglected from here onwards. This is neglected. Then what I'm doing, I'm representing a very wide number into a short number, right? So what will be the effect on neglecting 8, 7, 5, 4, 2? Okay, that we have to study. So when I neglect 8, 7, 5, 4, 2 and so on numbers, this type of method of fitting a number is called as a truncation, that we truncate or stop the numbers wherever required, and then rest all the numbers are neglected. So this is called as a truncation. Whereas in rounding, the same number will be written as 10.201562. Now there are two ways of rounding. Either I will keep it 3 as it is. If I keep 3 as it is, then it will not be a rounding, but it will be truncating. So what rule that we use in maths is, if the number is above 5, then I will round off the next digit to next higher one. Like for example, this is 8, which is above 5. So I will round 3 to 4 instead of keeping it 3. So I will round the 8 to 3 as 4. And I am neglecting 7, 5. So there is one rounding and rest neglected. What you can do further is, you can start rounding off. So here there will be 0 rounding. 2 round off with 4 is 4 only. 4 round off with 5 will 5 only, because this is, these 2 are less than 5. This is equal to 5. This will be rounded off to 8. 8 will be rounded off to 9. And 9 will be rounding the 3 to 4. And that will be the final one. Correct. So in this, the last digits are rounded such that I am considering the next higher bit. Okay. If suppose instead of 8, there would be, let's say, 1, then what I'll do? I'll round to a lower value, isn't it? So what we are considering is, in rounding, suppose I have, okay, I have a number which, let's say, lies in between these two regions. So these are two regions, okay, and the number is lying in between these two regions. Then either I will come down to this level or either I will go up to this level. So that is called as a rounding. So rounding can give me a plus minus approximation or a plus minus error expectation, whereas truncation will always give me a minus. It will not be always minus, it will, in some cases it will also be plus, but in general it will be the lesser number, so it will be minus. Okay, so this is how we use the methods called truncation and rounding. So why we need truncation and rounding? Only because the resistor length in the processors are fixed. They are either 8 bit, 16 bit or 32 bit. Max to max, we can go up to 64 bits by combining the resistors, but not beyond that. But when we are dealing with fractions, it might happen that I will write 3 by 4, okay, that has to be represented using a fixed resistor number, but a ratio of two numbers is an irrational number, it will go forever. It might happen there would be a recurrence of number, or it might happen that the number will terminate at after many digits. Okay, so the representation of the binary might not always be 8 bit or 16 bit or 32 bit or 64, but might be greater than that. So such fractions has to be brought down to either 8 bit if we are working with 8 bits, or 16 bits if we are working with 16 bits, and so on and so forth. So in this way, we either need to use truncation or rounding in practical application for fitting the data that is available to us in the given processor resistors. So in this way, we have two methods, truncation and rounding. I hope that you have understood what you mean by truncation and rounding. Thank you.